Every day, we make use of meaningful technologies. But how are they created? One individual isn't enough to make a difference. But what about a whole team of people? So let's go back in time, back to 30 years ago when Prodrive Technologies first came into existence.
It started in 93, or actually with an idea in 92 on the Eindhoven University, where I met Hans Verhagen. And together we thought it would be an interesting idea to commercialize the knowledge that we built around digital control and power electronics. The projects that we did were not as big as we do right now. Engineers had a very broad responsibility in the whole project.
These days everybody has his own specific responsibility, and at that time you had a broader responsibility. You had to design the schematics, but also the CAD symbols, do the routing, purchasing, and when the components arrive, you also had to assemble the products yourself.
Well, the first products were actually a number of controllers, a combination of digital and analog technology in different levels and scales. And we also developed on a certain moment a TIM module, and TIM stands for Texas Instruments module. It's based on the most advanced DSP that TI had in that time.
A DSP which runs at 40 megahertz, and even my watch is nowadays faster than that, so it's not that impressive anymore. But it was one of the first processors or CPUs that was able to do multi-processor, multi-core computing.
The idea was to create a building block that you can use in different applications, providing computing power, basically.
And the TIM was more or less an off-the-shelf product, but it was also kind of designed for ASML because it was already known that they were using that module. So we had immediately a customer for that module.
With the success of the TIM module, Prodrive Technologies started their journey of rapid growth. In 97, they moved to the Science Park in Eindhoven, where soon after they would start to not only design their products, but manufacture them in-house.
Well, in the first years of Prodrive, we outsourced our manufacturing.
The quality of production could be much better, and we thought always, well, we can do it better. And that's also triggered us. Maybe we should start producing ourselves, then we have everything under control.
It created much more control about how to design a product that can be manufactured in a very efficient way with a high level of automation, how to close the loop very effectively, and take an end-to-end responsibility towards our customers so that we in an early stage could commit to what the end result would be for the customer.
The first product we developed for Philips Healthcare was the DFI2. It was an image processing system applied in mobile Röntgen equipment. And we won this case not due to the fact that we were so big, because we were actually too small, but due to the fact that we made a smart concept. This concept resulted in lower cost, in a smaller unit, and therefore a perfect fit for Philips Healthcare.
In-house manufacturing and optimizing systems had become one of the core focuses at Prodrive Technologies, and as a result, their product range became more advanced. But in December of 2018, tragedy struck.
December 1st, I was sleeping and I got a phone call at around 5 o'clock, I think. Hey, there is a fire at Prodrive.
My wife actually looked up what was going on, and she found out in the news that it concerned Prodrive.
Very early in the morning, John Beekendam called me and he told me the story that there was something happening at Prodrive. So at that time I got in the car, and of course we could not get anywhere because complete Eckersreit was closed off.
I realized for the first time, the days after, I should say, that we are really an organization instead of this small company anymore, because a lot of people, we are with so many people helping out, and it was incredible that we managed to get out of this situation in this short time.
It was really very heartwarming to see how many people and suppliers, clients were also helping us, offering all kind of help to survive this crisis. Looking back, I think the combination of this help with enormous efforts of the Prodrive workers, Prodrive team, that worked really day and night. yeah, it was a very stressful, but again, the recovery was also a grateful thing.
With the help of many others, Prodrive Technologies was able to rebuild itself. As a result, the company has been able to continue to grow and pursue new ventures.
Well, in the future, I see more growth, and that growth will mean that we will open new facilities, expand our current presence in Son, near Eindhoven, where we have our headquarters. We have a factory in Suzhou, China, and one in Boston, USA.
Prodrive chose Suzhou, China, mainly because it can make products more cost competitive. At the same time, it brings the foundation there for accessing to Asian markets, selling Prodrive products to Asian customers.
With the North American market as one of our major growth regions, it was a logical step to establish an entity here in Boston. The automation in our factory and a great engineering team will remain a combination which will not only differentiate in the US, but all over the world.
For three decades, we have been creating meaningful technologies that make the world work. And we are ready for the next 30 years.